name is Akeisha and I'm doing the Taking the Plunge Challenge. Don't you love how learning about science enables us to solve interesting and unusual problems? I'm building my own submersible to retrieve an object. But to do it, I'm going to need some help. Welcome to Questacon.
Hey Akeisha, how are you going with your Taking the Plunge Challenge?
Well, one of the objects I need to recover is inside a cylinder. So I'm wondering, what could I build to retrieve it?
That's a fantastic question. Ask is the first step of the engineering design process. You've identified a problem. Now you can use the rest of the steps of the process to help you design a solution. Imagine, plan, create, and improve. So what solutions can you imagine?
Well, I could use a vacuum or a grabbing claw or even a hook. I wonder what they do in the real world to retrieve items underwater.
I know someone who can show you.
Hi, Keisha. I'm Harry.
Hi.
I'm a Navy engineer. I hear you want to learn about retrieving things underwater.
Yes, please.
That's great. As a Navy engineer, I use the engineering design process every day to solve problems just like yours. Let's go to the Navy Innovation Centre. The Navy have a range of remotely operated vehicles just like this one.
That's so cool.
Yeah, so they are underwater robots that we control from the surface. The Navy uses them for things like inspecting our Navy ship hulls or propellers. Or if a rope gets tangled, we can use this to untangle it or recover an object from the seafloor.
But how does it grab things underwater?
This is a hydraulic arm, which is made up of three parts. We have the control system here that is connected through a long cable that provides power and communications to our underwater robot. The hydraulic arm itself has small actuators inside here that allow it to move and rotate. On the end, we have a grabber, and we use this to grab and pick up objects and other things.
How does the arm itself move?
A hydraulic system enables us to control the movement of the arm by applying pressure to different chambers of oil inside it. By pushing or pulling oil to different parts of the hydraulic arm, force is passed on to make it bend and straighten. So, would you like to have a try?
Yes. It's moving just like my arm.
That's right. So your arm uses your muscles and electrical signals from your brain to control it, where this hydraulic arm uses oil, metal, and electronics to do the same thing. So now that you've got the hang of it, would you like to go recover an object?
Yes.
So, Akeisha, now you've seen how Navy engineers use remotely operated vehicles to recover things from the seafloor, good luck with the rest of your challenge.
Yes, thank you so much. I had a great day. Okay, so I'm back at Questacon and it's time to create my submarine. Using the parts I have, I've made my submarine in a size and shape that fits in the cylinder.
That's a great solution, Akeisha. I can see it works well. Using the engineering design process, the final step is improve. Can you think of anything you'd like to change?
I'd love to improve my design so that it can be used in more ways. I'd love to use hydraulics to create a claw that opens and closes, just like the one the Navy uses. What ideas do you have?